Sure, so come and join them for that. and they're going to be planning out their year at that meeting. HARP is meeting on September 5th at 11 a.m., and George Pullman is coming, so he's going to do finances for seniors. So if you would like to hear about budgeting and how to work your finances as you age, that's a good HARP meeting to come to. Rareshaw Ministry is continuing, and Amy, thank you for heading that up. And they'll be meeting on Tuesday at 10 a.m. and also on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. And our confirmation class is forming. We do have a bunch of confirmands that are ready to go and ready to be confirmed. So the parents meeting will be October 1st. So make sure you have that on your calendar. And if you know someone, sixth grade or up, that is looking to be confirmed, please send them my way. Water Sunday is September 10th, so don't forget we have the vials out still to get your water from your sacred spaces. Bring it back to worship on the 10th, and we're going to bless it, and we're going to use that for all of our baptisms and all of our anointings that we do throughout the year. And Pride is today, so some of our members and I are going to be at Pride representing, so that's an exciting thing. We'll get to meet lots of people. And last night, we were at Night in the Country representing and saw a whole bunch of people. We had kids' crafts and a spinning wheel for kids, and it was great. So thank you to all the volunteers, especially Carol, who really kind of spearheaded that one. So hopefully you'll decide to get involved with that next year. Some people news. Barbara is at rehab, so continue to keep her in your prayers. Linda is at Lehigh Valley Cedar Crest. Please keep her in your prayers. Esther was transferred to Luther Crest in rehab, so keep her in prayer. And Janet is still recovering at home. And of course, we keep Dolores in our prayers, who is in home hospice. Is there anything else I may have missed? I know that was a lot. All the information is in your bulletin. There's lots going on because we are headed into the fall season, so make sure to read it. Okay, let us prepare our hearts and minds to worship by listening to our prayer. Take a deep breath in. And let's let the sounds of nature be our favorite. As we center and as we listen to God's music, we are prepared. We are ready to worship our God together. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey,
you are welcome here.
Who are we as Christ's church?
Together our church is welcoming, embracing, giving, celebrating. Together our mission is no matter who you are.
Oh, right. I'm trying.
Joining our voices together in the prayer of confession. Forgive us,
O God, for the sin we recognize in ourselves and the wounds we do not see. Show us how we have hurt one another and grant us courage to seek forgiveness and reconciliation. Reveal to us our disobedience to you and keep us from leading others to our sin. Receive your mercy for the times we have willfully offended. Help us to put aside all actions and comments that defile. Cleanse us for a new life in Christ. Amen.
Our God is a God of second chances. relationship with us. Through the power of the Holy Spirit and Jesus Christ, we are indeed a forgiven people. Thanks be to God for a love like that. Amen.
Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Psalms, chapter 133. How very good and pleasant it is when kindred live together in unity.
It is like the precious oil on the head, running down on the beard of Aaron, running down over the collar of his robes.
It is like the dew of Hermon, which falls from the mountain of Zion, for there the Lord ordained his blessing, life forevermore. The gospel reading today is from the book of Matthew, chapter 15, verses 21 to 28. Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed from that moment. Here ends the gospel reading.
Well, the children want to come up, those that want to come up. Come on up. Let's chat for a little bit. You guys are going to stay there, Cameron? Okay. Good morning. Good morning. How are you? Good. Good morning, Samantha. All right. I was hoping maybe you could help me act out a little bit today's scripture reading. Okay? So we're going to put things inside the circle, okay? So who is inside the circle in our story? So who is speaking? Do you remember? Jesus is inside the circle. So can we pick one to be Jesus and put Jesus inside the circle? Okay. Put Jesus inside the circle. There you go. All right. And the 12 disciples were there. So can we take 12 ducks and put them on the inside? 4, 5. Okay, so that was good. All right, we got more than enough disciples down there, right? So we have Jesus and the disciples, and they're inside the circle, but you know what? There was somebody in our story that was on the outside. Who wants to put this little duck on the outside of the circle? On the outside, yes. There was a woman on the outside of the circle, and she wanted to come on the inside. She wanted Jesus to help her daughter, right? And that one, yeah, isn't that a cute one? Okay, so she wanted Jesus to help her daughter. So she tried to get on the inside. You want to put her on the inside? Okay. She tried to get on the inside, and she talked to Jesus. And Jesus said, "You know what? You're right. God wants everybody to be inside the circle, right?" And he helped her daughter. Yeah. So guess what happened to the circle? In the story, the circle went away, right? And then what happened to all the rest of the people?
It fell down.
All inside the circle, right? Yeah. Right? Because God loves everybody. All right. Can you say a prayer with me and repeat after me? Let's pray. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you that there are no circles
and everyone is welcome. And all God's people say,
Amen.
Now don't go too far, okay?
I have a little story to tell you.
You see what I have? You know what these are? Dum-dums, right? Well, when I had a dance studio, I used to hand out dum-dums after dance class to all the kids when they did a good job, right? And one of those kids was a little baby, and sometimes his mommy had a little bit of trouble with him. And she would say, I don't know if he deserves a dum-dum, but I'd take big old Elijah over there. And I'd take him in the room and I'd say, here, take a dum-dum. So, could you do me a favor? Because I think everybody here is good. Can you go pass around the dum-dums to make sure everybody gets one? All right, make sure everybody gets a dum-dum.
And Kendra always did good in dance class, I'm just saying.
You may take oh, what a helper.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You can turn out like you like, okay? Put it over here and everybody can pick one too, okay?
Anybody that wants to talk, feel free to take one. Yeah. Goodness. You better pass up the water. Oh, no. Well, that's okay. A pad. I almost took two.
It is held in Center County Grange Fairgrounds in Center Hall. It starts on a Thursday and ends on a Sunday. Wow. You may ask what the Grange is. It's a family community organization that was started in 1867. It is dedicated to the betterment of the American way of life through community service, legislation, and fellowship. It is for all members of the family. This year in October at Morgantown in Berks County, we will be celebrating the 150th anniversary. The Grange Family Festival was started 20 years ago. So we were celebrating. campground is about 20 minutes from State College. David and Elisa and we go a day early because we like to set up and socialize a little bit. There's a couple other people that are there early. And then we go eat supper, and then we play games the rest of the night. We like the extra time to socialize and relax. Thursday morning, we go to a restaurant near the campground for breakfast, and then we drive to State College and see what all the changes are in the surrounding area. Our daughter, Renee, has a veterinary office on West College Avenue, and we drove to see her project that she had. She bought the house next to her practice and tore it down for a parking lot. And she has to have spot for 30 employees and for clients. And right now, she is in the process of removing two of the walls, or they are, and she's adding on to her business. And the place looks like a bomb hit. She said, I asked her when she's finished. She said, it'll be next summer. People start coming to camp Thursday afternoon. Some come in RVs and campers, and some are sleeping in army tents that the fairground puts up for the day. Thursday after supper, we had our opening. Our president and national president both are so. And then we take dinner at the evening, which it does each evening. Meals are served daily. We get 8 meals for $54, and it's all you can eat. Breakfast is a huge hit.
What a bargain.
The kids really love it. They serve us French toast, pancakes, plain with blueberries or chocolate chips, and then whipped cream on top for these crazy people. Eggs any way you want. Omelets, fried potatoes, sausage links, scrapple, and bacon. All kinds of breads and toast, all kinds of cereals, and all kinds of drinks if you can imagine. Friday night was chilly night. And we were asked to bring chili to compete. I won second place.
All right.
Seven contestants. We have workshops for crafts and speakers. Our people wanted more free time, so they cut back on the setting up programs. Last year, the fairgrounds rented the craft fair at the same weekend that we are there. And we can walk to that area. So the Grange cut back on events so we can go see what's at the craft fair. Crafts this year were making barn quilts. Now the people that do barn quilts, that's what they do almost that whole entire weekend.
Beautiful.
We made all of these. Rick has this book of all the barn quilts. With Lisa's help and mine, but he does all the artwork, we've made over 30 barn quilts. Eugene has two of these barn quilts. We had a speaker from the Susquehanna service dog for the deaf, and a deaf woman was with her dog. The Grange has a deaf and community service committee, and always has a speaker, and the committee presents them with a donation. Our Grange legislative consultant, Carrie Hayes, had a workshop. She talked about the happenings in Harrisburg and how the Grange has helped with the broadband. Our national president has been working in Washington with this committee. She and She was also invited by Senator Bob Casey to talk about the investment in the broadband in Pennsylvania. She talked about the budget of agriculture and rural PA, property tax and rent rebate, dairy policy, and solar issues. And she asked all the Grangers to give her her email address so that she can send legislative Zooms to everyone. Cornhole competition was busy every day, from morning till night. The junior Grangers, who are 5 to 14 years of age, were busy. They had their own events every day. They had water games on Friday, and Saturday they had bike races around the camping tent and raised money for community service, and the kids won money depending on how many laps they did. Plus, they had a lot of meetings and learning different things. Friday night, we had movie night, and we saw The Greatest Showman with popcorn and ice cream sundaes. Saturday night was talent night and introduction of royalty that was selected at junior and youth camp 2 weeks earlier. We had a huge birthday cake for our 150th celebration. Sunday ended with worship service, and our pastor was someone I knew from Grange Youth Camp back in the 1960s. It was 3 days of renewing old lifetime friendships and making new friends. The youngest there was 6 months old, and that family slept in a tent, and the oldest was 92. The Grange is the only organization where the whole family can attend together except the church.
I was going to say, yeah. What church?
You accept everybody, right?
Well, as you know, I'm doing just a mini reflection, and I'm trying to tie the scripture into the story of the day. And what I heard was a lot of welcome at the Grange, right? Mm-hmm. And there was something for everyone, right?
Right.
Yeah. So you had the sip and paint for people, you had crafts, you had kids' stuff, you had worship, all these things for all these different people. Is everyone welcome there?
Yeah, you don't have to be a Grange member.
Yeah. See, everyone is welcome. There is no one outside that circle. Everyone is welcome. And what a great community that is, right? So in our story today, Jesus is with his disciples, and the disciples are getting a little angry because there's this woman trying to interrupt and wants a little bit of help. And the disciples are saying, but no, you know, you came here for us, for the Jewish people. Now you have to remember, in Matthew's gospel, it was primarily written for Jewish people. So it was starting with the Jewish people that Jesus came for. And then it was supposed to expand out. But at this moment in the story, it was only supposed to be the Jewish people that Jesus was helping and that Jesus was preaching and teaching to. And so the disciples are getting a little frustrated that this woman is trying to interrupt this. And she is persistent. Isn't she in the story? She is so persistent. She's like, I need you, Jesus, right? So she continues and continues and tries to get Jesus to help her daughter. And what happens is Jesus actually has a conversation with this woman. He has a conversation with her to figure out what's going on. And she has such great faith. She knows who Jesus is, and she wants Jesus to help her. And Jesus listens to her. And what we don't always see is Jesus changing his mind. Right? We don't always see that. Jesus listens to her and changes his mind and helps her and helps her daughter because of her faith. So what I'd like you to think about is when you are having a situation, are you taking the time to have those conversations? to really listen to one another, to hear where one another is coming from. Because if Jesus can do it, I think we can do that too. And I think we see God more clearly when we don't all agree about everything, right? Because God is in every single one of us. And we're not all going to think exactly the same, right? But there's beauty in that. And we see God more fully when there is no circle, when there is no insiders and outsiders, when there is just us, children and people of God. That is what I think God wants for us. And that is what I think we need to work toward every single day. Thanks be to God. Oh, and I have a question for you. Do you feel welcomed here?
Of course.
Yeah? Do you feel welcomed? Okay. So what, if you want to shout out, like, tell me, what do you feel, what makes you feel welcome here?
You.
Not me, the pastor is not the church. What else?
Everybody, the members, everybody. Yeah. The people.
Yeah. The people, right?
Everybody seems happy to see you.
Yeah, exactly. We're like glad you're here, right?
Right.
Yeah. What would it help people that aren't from our community, that are visitors that come in? What would help them to feel? Now I know we do a really good job of this. I will say that we do a really good job of this. But how could we continue to be that welcome, that place of welcome for all people?
Invite a newcomer.
Exactly. Invite someone to sit with you. How nice that would be, so they don't have to sit alone, especially if they come in alone, right? What happens if they sit in your pew? What happens?
You find another pew,
right? There's a story about someone came into a church. I won't say what church it was, but somebody came into a church and they sat in someone's pew. Right? First time in the church, they sat in someone's pew. Do you know the people that they sat with? Because they wound up sharing the pew together, and they didn't say anything. They shared the pew together. They are the best of friends. They go everywhere together. They have formed such a wonderful relationship, all because she sat in the wrong pew. Right? So that's something we could do, too, is be willing to lend a seat to someone if they're sitting in our pew, right? When was the time that you felt unwelcome? Because I'm sure we've all felt that at some point.
When we travel, we try to stop at a different church of different denominations.
Yeah.
And we actually were ready to get in, walk into a community and say nothing. And we were actually told that that's where so-and-so sits.
Wow.
That's unwelcoming. Good for you. You were the bigger person, right?
Wow.
Anybody else? I've already told you my story about not being welcomed at the communion table, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think I told you that.
Yeah.
I went to a celebration of life and at a church, and I was told, just so you know, you're not able to take communion here. Yeah. It was a Catholic.
Of course.
I wasn't going to say it. Anybody else? And it doesn't have to be church. Like, when have you felt unwelcome? Cliques, right?
Yeah.
When there's cliques, like it's, especially in school. For those of you that are like in college or in high school, there could be a lot of cliques, right? Yeah. Where like there's people and they are insiders and you're the outsider, right? And that's very unwelcoming, right? When they don't want to associate with you.
Classroom.
Classroom.
I was called back to sub the end of the school year because I'm strict. And when I walked in the classroom, the kids all, oh no, it's her again.
Yeah. We've all felt both, right? We've all felt welcome and unwelcome. So keep doing what you're doing, friends, because we are definitely a welcoming community.
Yes,
so keep up the good work. Be Jesus for others. Amen. Thank you.
receives our joys and concerns, let us offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation. O God, your Spirit gathers the church. Shepherd those who are newly baptized and newly ordained in the proclamation of the gospel. Breathe life into the ecumenical and interreligious endeavors, and support missionaries throughout the globe. Hear us, O God. You created the earth and all its inhabitants and declared it good. Clean, pollute the skies, sea and soil, provide nourishment to plants and animals, and make us aware of their impact on the environment. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You call leaders to bridge differences and practice generosity. Inspire all in authority to protect people in harm's way. Deliver those in bondage, support fair elections, provide care for military personnel and veterans, and show mercy to those for whom they have responsibility. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You provide for those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Embrace people who have been rejected because of difference. Heal trauma caused by racism or prejudice. Shield any who are persecuted. Console the dying and heal the sick. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Strengthen those who feel faint. Give courage to those who fear and bring wholeness to those in need, especially the Kensick family, Jack, Len, Guy, Bob and Doris, Fox family, Jean, Linda, Pat. For those in the prayer chain, we keep in our prayers, and for those not mentioned in our hearts. We also pray for our weekly partner in ministry, New Life and New Tripoli, this week. Bless them as they continue serving Christ in the community and beyond. We pray all of this in the name of Jesus Christ, who first taught us to pray, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Number one fan. brother.
Share a quick story with you. We were at Night in the Country last night, and we had the opportunity to talk to a whole bunch of people from our area, and it was really awesome to meet so many people in our community. But what struck me was, and I had a lot of great conversations, but there was one conversation in particular. There was a gentleman that came over to the booth, and he said, "I've been hurt by the church." He said, "I've been struggling for a long time, but I really want to get back to church. Will your church welcome me just as I am?"
Will your church welcome me if I wear a t-shirt and I have dirty pants and dirty shoes? I said, absolutely. Absolutely. This is a place where people can heal. This is who we are called to be. Doesn't matter what clothes we wear. God welcomes us no matter what. And I know we are the kind of community that would welcome anybody, no matter what they looked like or what they had on. So go from this place knowing that every conversation you have can make a difference not only in your own heart, but in the heart of someone else's. So go from this place and share that welcome and that love with everyone you meet. Amen.
Amen.
Since we all are such a welcoming congregation, it's Pastor Michelle's birthday.
Oh. I'm 30 again.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Yeah, lots of wood up here.